Hi, Tappers. Did you know that EFT is great for things other than trauma?
Yeah.
Promise. There have been entire studies showing that EFT is also unbelievably effective at peak performance stimulation. What does that mean? It allows you to access your best self and ability in challenging situations. This could be right before you go on stage to deliver a speech in front of 1,000 people, as you go play a game you were paid millions to help win, or go on set to deliver the most convincing love scene when you've been on set for 20 hours, you're hungry, and you don't like the other actor. None of that's relatable. Okay. How about trying to restart a morning exercise routine? Or have more patience and connection with your loved ones after a crappy work day? Having a hard conversation with your friend to go see the doctor that they've been avoiding? In all of those situations, you want your head to be clear, your intentions specific, and distractions and blocks eliminated. EFT helps you get present, get and stay focused, and release what is trying to pop up in the moment to sabotage you. Sabotage! This works the same way releasing trauma does. You are communicating with your subconscious brain and telling it what is relevant. There are a few differences in the application of it, though. First, it is used as a practice tool, meaning if you are working to get good at basketball, you would use EFT peak performance at every practice. Second, instead of the setup statement, you use an affirmation that is a quick phrase to focus in on your intention. I had a friend who was an excellent football player. He caught some crazy throws. I found out one evening that he had an affirmation that he wrote on his hands before every game. Catch the ball. Third, you visualize the outcome with intense emotion. Not how you get there, not what you have to overcome for it, but that delicious, victorious moment where it's over and you got it. Remember, the subby doesn't know the difference between your vivid thoughts and reality. Also, remember the subby sets a high priority to bring to pass that which you believe. Convince it that when the moment is hot and the pressure is on and it's all up to you, you already know that you come through like a breeze and you slay it. It's not an overwhelming moment because, well, you already know it's okay. I used this technique when giving a high-stakes testimony in court against a federal criminal. The opposing counsel was known for being obnoxious and particularly enjoying trapping the witnesses in wordplay to fluster and anger them so that they would forget details and seem less credible. Before I was invited in, I centered myself in the moment, cleared my mind, and only let in seeing me being the strongest voice in there, that I would see through any traps that he tried to lay for me, that every time he spoke, it was an opportunity for me. And that was exactly what happened. I kept my cool. I was commanding and poised, and I wiped the floor with him, and it mattered. For most of that case, I was a dissociated mess, but because I used these three steps, I was able to be at my peak when it mattered. How about a real life test now? You're going to need enough room to rotate with your elbows sticking out like this. Sit up nice and straight, place your hands on your shoulders, and look over your right arm. Twist towards your right until you can't go further. Look past your elbow and remember that spot. Now look over your left and do the same thing. Let's do it once more each side, just to show it's not because we loosened the lid, per se. Okay, now create a phrase about being able to twist further. I will use, I love my flexible waist. Now let's tap. Just go through all of the points once with this. It's a quick demo. And say your phrase. I love my flexible waist. I love my flexible waist. I love my flexible waist. Love my flexible waist. Love my flexible waist. Create as much excitement and joy with it as you can. Remember, you are looking to convince your subby it is the way. Now close your eyes and keep tapping. Just choose a point and move along as you want to, or stay on the same one. Now see yourself twisting again to the right, and you go 6 inches further. Wow! Now see yourself twist to the left, and you twist completely backwards. What? That's so crazy. And one final twist takes you to the right, and you twist all the way around until you're facing forward again. Wow, you really are the most twisty, flexible person. Oh my goodness, I freaking love my flexible waist. Okay, open your eyes and stop tapping. Take a breath. Ready to do it? Arms up, twist to the right, looking over your elbow. Did you pass your previous spot? Let's do the left. Yeah! This is the smallest sample, tappers, of how you can use EFT for peak performance. Let me know how else you want to see this in action, and we'll do it together. I'll see you soon.